Everyone is teaching prompt formulas, but the best AI users never just follow formulas. They design thinking. To effectively learn AI prompting, we have to first let go of the mindset that we are giving instructions to AI models. In fact, we're not just writing prompts, we're conveying our thinking process through prompting. Sure, there are different prompt generators to craft your prompt, and nowadays AI is so good at writing prompts. We'll get there in a minute. But that doesn't mean you shouldn't learn AI prompting, because the thinking behind the prompt matters more than the prompt itself. And it started with the first one, transparent reasoning. Most people get wrong about prompt formulas is that they treat prompting like a recipe, focusing on getting the prompt parameters right. It's just like checking boxes. But essentially, prompting is a conversation. It should be dynamic, it's floating, reflecting your thought process. To give you an idea, here is a standard prompt about a go-to-market strategy planning task for a UX research SaaS. Following the typical prompt formula with the role, task, context, it works, but you can see the proposed plan is more general and can be applied in so many different cases. But this time, if we share more about our thinking process about the task, like why we're doing this, our assumption, constraint, you can see the output would be much better, more strategic and specific to the situation. So first, state your goal or core task, and then share your reasoning, your why, assumption, constraint, success criteria, anything that can explain your thinking to AI about your task. And this will massively improve your output response because you're telling AI not just what you want, but what is your reasoning process. And now AI is matching its output to your thinking approach, so it will produce a result that is much more satisfying. Sharing your reasoning is powerful, but you can also learn from others' thinking as well. So that leads into the next AI prompting skills, reverse prompting. Reverse prompting is especially useful when your design output has a specific style, voice, or nuance that is difficult to describe, but it's instantly recognizable using an example because AI is so good at pattern matching. For example, your company wants a product announcement or marketing message to sound more like a brand you admire, like how Shopify does. It's very hard to ask AI to sound like Shopify. It's just too broad for this specific case, but you can show it as an example. So you can first ask it to analyze the patterns like tone of voice, structure, language patterns, persuasion techniques, target audience signals noticed in the copy. And then it will pull up a really detailed analysis for you with examples. And then you can follow up with a prompt asking it to generate a copy-paste-ready prompt template. So now you have this ready-to-use template that you can apply in any kinds of product announcement in the future that mimics the tone that you want. And not just for copy, you can use it for images as well. So upload any image that you like and first ask AI to analyze any pattern that it notices. And you can see the output is super detailed. And then you can ask it to generate the image prompt for you that can produce a similar result. So you can immediately increase the chance of success to generate a new image that have a similar style and texture. So first ask AI to analyze the pattern it recognizes in any output. It can be text, image, depending on its model capability. And then ask it to generate the exact prompt based on the analysis that will create a similar result. Of course, that doesn't mean the prompt is perfect. You have to test it and adjust, but that will give you an immediate starting point. So reverse prompting helps you extract the success thinking pattern behind any great output, but sometimes you might already have some great examples or framework that you want AI to follow. And then you can use field shot prompting. So field shot prompting is a very classic AI prompting technique where you provide a few examples, usually 2 to 3, right in the prompt itself. So it helps AI understand the pattern that you're looking for and replicate them in your output and immediately improve the response. So like this example about creating a LinkedIn thought leadership post without including any examples. Of course, it will still work, but you can see the results is not that specific and feels really generic. But now if we try to include 2 to 3 LinkedIn post examples, by the way, these are real LinkedIn post example from Stephen Bartlett, and then ask it to create a LinkedIn post that challenge a common business assumption. So you can see the results will be much better and is really following Stephen's style that using first person point of view and is much more emotionally engaging. So first gather 2 to 3 best example for your task, paste them in your prompt, and then label each example clearly, as long as it's clear. and then ask AI to match this style or following this pattern. A bonus tip is you can apply the same concept by uploading all your best example in your project as a knowledge file. Although it can't be strictly be considered as a few shot prompting technique, you still achieved a similar purpose by guiding AI about what quality output looks like. And if you want, you can even combine both of these techniques in the same prompt. So once you start providing clear examples or knowing how to ask it to reverse engineering patterns, the next powerful skills is getting AI to help you craft even better prompts or reusable prompts and act like your prompting coach. And that is meta prompting. It sounds technical, but meta prompting is really about asking AI to create, improve, or explain prompts instead of giving you a response. For example, you are a product marketer at Squarespace, the website building platform, with a spreadsheet full of raw customer feedback. And your goal is to extract these actionable insights for the product team, but you don't know how to prompt the AI. So you can first state your goal, which is to identify the top 3 to 5 most critical product improvement suggestions, and you need a prompt, and then ask for the information or context that it needs in order to craft an effective prompt. And then it will immediately pull a list of relevant questions for you. So answer this question, and then it will give you the exact prompt you need for your task, and it even gives you a prompt template so that you can reuse in the future. And now you can test the prompt to see its output and adjust it. But I would say using this method is very effective, and these identified critical product improvements are exactly what we want. And meta prompting isn't just about creating better prompts from scratch, but also use AI to critique and improve your own prompting approach. So for example, you had a long back and forth conversation with AI about brainstorming a launch strategy for your online course, and it has just produced a brilliant summary of the launch plan. So now you can just ask it to base on the entire discussion and give you a prompt template that can generate a similar high quality launch plan for a different online course in the future. And immediately you turn AI into a prompting coach for you. So first define your end goal, clearly state the ultimate outcome you want to achieve, and then ask AI for any extra information that it needs from you to craft the perfect prompt for your goal. And then provide these extra context to AI to create the final prompt. So meta prompting can help you generate a sophisticated prompt, but sometimes you just don't want to try to execute them all at once, especially if it's more complex tasks. And that's why we have chain prompting. So it literally really means guiding AI through a logical step-by-step, with each prompt building on the last that creates just like a chain. For example, you are a consultant preparing a response for an RFP from a high-value client. We can then first ask it to identify the top 4 core needs from this client, and that means what success criteria this client looks for. So it will immediately pull the top success criteria that we must meet in order to succeed. And now, assuming you're consultants at Accenture, the second prompt, you can further ask it to create a narrative which can frame the unique approach to demonstrate the capabilities across these areas to maximize the chance of getting selected. And then it will propose the narrative for you to address these criteria. And then the final prompt, you can ask it to draft this methodology section of the proposal, which is worth 20% of the evaluation score. You can see the final response will be much better with the proposed methodology that ties back to the top concern. So it will be much more impactful because every step is built on the previous one and improving the clarity to approach the task effectively. So first, use AI to understand and deconstruct the core problem. That is the cross of your task to be done. Use AI to formulate the best strategy or approach to get this done. And ask AI to execute based on the agreed approach so everything is interconnected. Chain prompting is really good for handling complex, multi-layer tasks where a single massive prompt would be ineffective, like crafting strategy, outlining marketing plans. A bonus is you can combine it with the meta prompting we just talked about. So for truly complex tasks, you can start with a meta prompt to have the AI to design a plan or roadmap for you. And then you can execute that plan step by step using a series of chain prompts. So you can really maximizing the impact from your prompting. Step by step prompting is good, but even the most well-structured thinking can be limited by your own single viewpoint. So that's why one of my favorite way is to ask AI to shift perspective. It can be your competitor, your target customer, your stakeholders, and that will give you multiple perspectives on the same issue. So for example, we have this SaaS product landing page copy from ActiveCampaign, and we can stress test it from multiple angles. So first, we can ask it to add as a head of sales to check if any critical information is missing, and that would help them pre-qualify leads, and if it can attract the clients that they want, your enterprise level clients. So it will immediately give you information that is suggested to add it back in a copy. And then we can also ask it to add as a marketing director of a competitor. What might be the biggest weakness in our messaging that we should address? And you can see AI will immediately pinpoint the areas we should improve. Then we can even ask it to add as our target customers from an enterprise corporate to check if this copy is something that they would resonate with or if it has answered their question. And it will give you what resonates and what might hold them back. So now you have a much more well-rounded perspective on the same issue to inspire your own thinking. So first, identify the specific items that you want to analyze. This could be marketing tagline, a strategic decision, a product features, and then choose a specific and relevant personas or lens through which you want to view this item. The more specific the persona, the better the feedback. So this is a really powerful way to move beyond just your assumption by testing any kinds of your output from different angles: landing page copy, proposal, important communication, product development. So you will always get lots of inspiration about what areas you might have missed. Now, another powerful prompting skill is to ask AI to do self-evaluation or self-reflection. So this can be incredibly useful because it forces AI to critically review its own output and identify blind spots in its own logic or expression. And personally, I use this a lot. For example, we are an AI presentation tool company, and we are reviewing the pricing strategy from the other three competitors. So we can first ask AI to analyze the pricing strategies by reviewing their pricing pages. So it will propose a pricing strategy based on its finding from these market players and how we can differentiate. And now we can follow up by asking it to critically review its pricing recommendation. So any factors is overlooked, any assumptions might be wrong, and how this analysis can be more strategic. And now it will provide all the overlooked factors or assumptions which might be wrong and provide counter suggestions on how to make it even more strategic. So this is especially good for complex problem solving, brainstorming strategy, and even doing data analysis. So first, give AI your initial prompt and get its first response, and then ask for a critique, like how could this be better, or what did you miss in that response? So this forces AI to reevaluate its own work, and then judge if the analysis makes sense and ask it to rewrite the response if necessary. Okay, picking one of these prompting skills, we immediately improve your output. But now we can even take a step further to combine all these AI prompting skills and build a mini prompting playbook that you can use anytime. So eventually, this will be like a system that references these prompting techniques and generate a prompt for you whenever you need it. So first, pull all the prompting skills with the step-by-step approach and examples in a Word document. And then open a new project on any AI that you like, ChatGPT, Gemini, Claude, and upload this as a project knowledge file and set up the custom instruction. So now you can just state whatever your goal is and let AI to build the initial prompt for you. Now I know what you might be thinking, shouldn't we just upload the internet resource about prompting to this project? But think of it like a curated prompt playbook, just tailor-made for your specific challenges. And so I encourage you to use examples that are super relevant for daily work needs and define how it should approach based on your preferred style. What are the prompting techniques that you find useful for your case? So to generate the prompts will always be much more personalized. Great prompting is never about memorizing formulas. It's about becoming a better thinker and communicator. So treat AI like your teammate who needs to understand your thinking in order to solve your problem. Join my community if you want to learn how to be more thoughtful of using AI in marketing. You will get access to all the actual prompts I use in all my channel videos, including this one, and our regular live session. You can find the link in the description to join. And before you go, also watch this video to learn about other essential AI skills that will give you immediate work advantage. I will see you next time.